God. And the key to that mystery is found in the heart of the Father.
There's good news. The Father loves us. Jesus came to redeem us, and in that redemption, the loving and merciful heart of the Father is revealed.
He longs for us to bring us home to the place where he dwells.
And so, as planned from the beginning, Jesus came.
Oh, sing aloud and rejoice. Exalt with all of your heart, for he has come and has taken away the judgments against you.
He has broken the bonds of slavery.
The Lord, this King of Israel, is in our midst.
So come home, come to the heart of the Father.
For an incoming of his Son Jesus, the Father has opened wide the gate of heaven for you and me.
He opened wide the gate so we could walk into all the joy and splendor of heaven. Open wide the gate so we could walk into all the joy and splendor of heaven. He opened wide the gate so we could walk into all the joy and splendor of heaven.
All the joy and splendor of heaven.
There's a dusty road that leads straight into Jerusalem. It's a road that Jesus has traveled many times before, but not like this. Not riding a donkey with crowds pressing in on every side.
They shouted, "Listen, he's coming! The prophet who raised Lazarus from the grave, he's coming! The one who healed our sons and daughters! It's the coming kingdom of our ancestor David!"
Hosanna in the highest! Make room for him! We've been hard-pressed, haven't we, and persecuted. But Jesus, you cured our blindness. You gave us legs to walk again.
And on the streets, they spread out their clothes and cut branches from the fields to honor him.
Amid a cacophony of voices, many are shouting praises, Others are not even aware of his coming. Soon, these same people will shout in condemnation.
The calling on the Master's life is about to be completed by his death. He fully recognizes the task. A crown awaits him, but first he must face Calvary. There is a debt to be paid, and Jesus will pay it in full. What language can we borrow to give thanks for such a friend?
Thank you.
last meal. It's clear now, there will be no mighty army to claim victory over the enemies of God's people. Jesus' triumphant entry into the holy city now seems like years ago instead of days. And it is to a table that Jesus leads his 12, not to a war.
It is at this table that they see the truth. Jesus loves them. He loves them with a mighty love, a love bigger than anything they've ever known. There he offers himself to them in the bread and the wine, his body and his blood. The weight of this mystery is overwhelming. The time is now. Jesus will stand in the darkness alone.
I count my time.
this friend of ruined sinners, this forgiver of his own executioners is slain.
A severe darkness covers the land. Let the whole earth tremble. The bread of heaven has fallen. How could the Son of God, the Savior of the world, end up like this?
Every single moment that has transpired since the foundation of the world was prelude to this. Behold, the Lamb of Glory.
Thank you.
the cross, the very instrument of death, now becomes the symbol of life.
The crown, so magnificent, now becomes the symbol of just how far God is willing to go to redeem us. If there is no cross, there is no crown.
And so Jesus, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness.
And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient to death, even death on a cross.
Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Jesus Christ is Lord.
To the glory of God the Father.